It's a beautiful spring day on Catacrom 4, Juanita.
Juanita!
Kick off a brand new season of Dread Zone.
That's right, Dallas. And we're lucky enough to have a bird's eye view of the action.
Even from up here, this season's Dread Zone battle courses look bigger and deadlier than ever.
It's a wonder contestants keep volunteering, isn't it?
That's a good one. Oh, yeah. The Vox construction team really outdid themselves in turning this once sacred robotic burial ground into a deadly Dread Zone battle course.
Here comes today's first contestant. Oh, my. They're really scraping the bottom of the barrel to find these guys, aren't they? I hope you folks at home aren't too squeamish, because the next one looks like a bleeder.
Ratchet's first objective is a gimme, Juanita. All he has to do is make his way to the other side of this mountain pass.
Oh my god.
Simple.
Right?
I lost half my health with a single bullet.
You did?
Yeah. Don't let the guy shoot you. Turrets. Bad turrets. I'm gonna go for a cover me! I died.
Defeating enemies automatically upgrades your Dread Zone weaponry and improves your maximum nanotech level.
You gotta do an EMP gun. Weren't you listening?
Oh, listening?
Circle to fire. It destroyed the cover! I have the EMP. Whoops.
I have two.
Oh my god!
Oh my god! You took all that stuff.
We share ammo!
you took it all. Woohoo! This is pretty much a third-person shooter, and I'm suck at shooter games.
Did you say I'm suck at shooter?
I'm suck at third-person shooters.
Oh, duh, EMP. Disables electronics. Oh, I love these things! What? What the hell? I did it! I did it my second try.
Whoa.
Oh, okay!
Yay.
You beat me. Okay. I'd like to take this moment to remind my viewers I fixed our problems with a piece of tape.
Yep.
Oh, the Landstalker! I forgot what this thing is, but it's awesome. It's a tank of some sort, I think. There it is.
The EMP is circle, or what is it?
You gotta hit the left arrow pad, and then hit circle. You see the thing in the corner there?
Oh, yeah.
Let's get some ammo. Max out ammo. Okay, you can max out this ammo and that ammo.
And then there's max out all
everything, which is the same exact price, just faster. It's cheap, though. Ammo is very cheap. Yeah. I want to say there's a skill point for doing this. Destroying all the cameras. I think there's a skill point for that, but it doesn't matter.
How do you switch back?
Oh, hey. I think the game pulls like 3 or 4 times to click in the right button to do something, but it just we never try it, though. Oh yeah, robot zombies! Right, these are a thing. Yeah, I'm not... Seriously, robot zombies. Just let that sink in for a minute. We just learned some... Oh crap! I forgot about that!
We can only go like so far apart from each other.
Just like our first LP!
Yay! Good time.
Both of your collars will explode.
Oh, both of your collars explode.
So yeah, it's instant death if we're too far apart for 10 seconds.
Oh shoot.
You have one thing. Oh crap.
I have one sliver of health left.
Land sharks! Well, go break open the health crates then. There's one here.
Where's one here. Oh, that's what it is.
There's one here. And there's one over there.
Well, I don't know what things are.
It's the one with the giant plus on it, which is usually a universal indication for health. Now come over here and collect it. I broke it open for you. There it is.
Yay.
Progress, but first robot zombie. Die. Which way do we gotta go?
Oh, they're gonna keep spawning.
There's two objectives. Okay, we gotta get to the Landstalker first. No! It's the giant red marker. We gotta turn that bull crank.
Yeah, don't get hit by these, because they do, like, five.
How do you get hit by them anyway?
Tried using my wrench.
You have much to learn. Let me try. It didn't work.
Jesus.
You want the shotgun instead?
No, it's okay.
It's much easier to use.
No, I like this thing. Makes things go boom.
Okay,
yeah, these guys are gonna keep respawning.
Yeah, let's move then.
Where are you going?
Over here.
What are the green boxes doing?
Vandalism! We got a skill point for vandalism. Oh, green box is ammo. You have not been paying attention to this game at all, have you?
I don't know.
Ratchet, according to Dread Zone show requirements, enemies appear red on the radar. Allies appear green. Challenge objectives appear blue.
And I got eaten by a thing. Hurry up before it comes back. And it's back. EMP. Before it destroys your cover, do it quickly!
Okay, I'm still learning.
I think a gun would work better.
I know, I think I'm still learning, okay.
It's a pretty simple game, bro.
I don't play PlayStation. What's that?
That is something that spawns more enemies. And then flies away. Great.
What's the other thing?
What? Yeah, it's a camera.
I shot it now.
Okay, it's for you. Last bolt crank. Hurry up!
I'm sorry. There's a zombie!
We increase our nano tech. Yeah, have you noticed like the experience bar above your health meter?
Yeah.
Have you noticed the experience bar below each weapon you highlight?
Yeah.
You can upgrade weapons also.
Okay.
Oh, help. Actually, no, I can just back away from them.
You can expand your map at any time to get a better view of the area.
That's the third time you told us this! Magma Cannon has reached level 2. Oh yeah, they like go up the levels. And if you level it up enough, I think you can buy super upgrades for them and crap. Since we've already established they infinitely respawn, shouldn't we just kind of move?
Yeah, that's true. But leveling up, man. Pet burning barbecue.
What?
Did I hear?
That's what I heard too. Let's just get to the tank.
Yeah.
Get to the chopper. All the swing shots in this game? Nice use of cover, boys. You suck. Oh, you just gotta put all your trust into.
Quit fooling around, Ratchet. Jump back up and try it again. Remember.
Oh, you have to equip the swing shot first. Thank you for that. And I died.
So what do I do?
Hold triangle, it said. And the swing shot is where?
You have it.
What? How did I get it?
I don't know.
Wait, what the hell?
You have it.
Try stepping closer to the target. You gotta be able to go across also. Just switch automatically.
Probably switches automatically because we can't hold the same items apparently. Bam! It was fun.
I don't understand.
Is that it or no?
It just tells me to hold R1 to. Is there a thing for equipment?
Okay.
I don't care. Equip the swing jump by pressing and holding triangle or R2 and pressing and holding square to bring up the alternate quick select menu. Now hold
Okay. What button did you use to get across?
Just fire with circle or R1. First, you have to equip it first, though.
I know it.
Oh, wait, what the hell? Oh, you gotta press circle though. You have your wrench out. Hit circle.
Circle.
And that pulls out your weapon.
Okay.
Now you got it. Hold the button down.
Gotcha.
Let me explain one thing first. If you press square, you have your wrench out, and you leave your wrench out until you hit the fire button to pull your weapon out. Honestly, that's something you wouldn't know unless you played other Ratchet and Clank games, though, so... But that's how it works, though.
That's how it works.
No. Anyway, tank is over there, but... Oh, duh. Oh, crap.
What do you know, folks? Ratchet has found the Landstalker!
Yay.
Now our next mission is to use the Landstalker and blow up a bunch of stuff. But I think you can get killed in it though, but it just takes a while.
This all-terrain mech of destruction comes fully loaded.
We're not even in the arena yet.
that's kind of depressing.
Small star system. Team Dark Star's not out for a Sunday drive.
Oh my god.
They'll be blazing a trail right into the center of the Catacomb Burial Dome.
Switch seats with L1. Is it like Mario Kart Double Dash where it's like, okay, 1, 2, 3, Z!
Charge mortars.
Oh, there's passenger and driver. I'm guessing I'm the driver.
Probably.
Charge mortars, fire mortars, and release. The mortars, you hold R1 and then you move the control stick around to lock on a target, so then you release it to fire all of them.
Okay.
Right. I think we can do this.
You will have to use the Landstalker's mortars to destroy those quasar orbs. That should clear the way.
Those mortars.
Yep. Come on. There we go. I'm just gonna keep on driving. I'm just gonna keep walking, and you're gonna shoot as much stuff as you possibly
can.
Okay,
I'm trying.
Jump! This freaking tank can jump. Juanita.
I don't see what we're supposed to get.
The thing that you need to fire the mortars with to destroy.
Ratchet is on a rampage with the Landstalker. Oh, I can't imagine the damage Bill Dreadzone is gonna get from this.
I need to kill that.
You can drive over a vehicle pad at any time to repair vehicle damage.
Vehicle repair pad where? Is that thing in the middle there? Whatever, we win.
Yay. We win!
It mentioned something about a vehicle repair pad, which I remember actually, but I didn't see one.
It's so funny because I'm so confused right now. Like, I'm just...
Like, this entire game is just, like, us very intently focusing on what we're doing.
I'm loving this carnage, folks. But it's time for the final showdown in the Catacomb Burial Dome. There's no telling what lurks inside these walls.
I know Tank to help us this time.
Great.
Ratchet, you must defeat all your opponents in order to complete this challenge. In other words, stay alive.
No problem! Wah. I think you can upgrade the wrench too, actually, if I remember correctly. You know, I was really weirded out that you press R1 to fire in this game, because in the other game there was always circle. Circle fires also.
Yeah, I noticed.
But honestly, if you're using the right stick to aim though, The shoulder button's easier. Round 3 out of 5. So we're over halfway done already. Yeah, you see why I hate that guy already?
Yeah.
He doesn't ever shut up.
Can we kill it? Yes, we can.
We can. Can we kill it?
Yes, we can.
I'm just gonna stop there.
I think I'm obsessed about conserving ammo.
Don't be. Are you serious? This arena is too small for us to... Oh, there goes all my ammo for the pistols.
Excellent work, Ratchet.
Yeah,
I must admit, I was worried.
And we got a green medal. And the hacker ray. I totally forgot how to use that thing.
Well done, Ratchet. You have completed your first Dread Zone campaign and won a medal. You have also unlocked a new set of objectives called Dread Challenges. Earning medals and defeating Dread Challenges are the key to survival in Dread Zone.
Okay.
You must earn Dread Points in order to unlock new planets.
Oh.
You can earn them by beating the Dread Challenges on any accessible planet.
Yeah.
Challenges can be completed in any order once they are unlocked.
That makes more sense.
Okay, then. How many points do we have? Current status, 0 Dread Points. Required, 5,000. No. See, 1,000, 1,000, 1,500.
Let's just do whatever. Might as well go back to the Dread Zone.
I guess, sure. I have no idea how I'm going to split these episodes up either. We're just going to record forever. We're going to record forever.
Forever. Never-ending recording session.
It seems that we can now that my duct tape fixed our problem with the disc freezing.
That's not duct tape.
Shut up. They don't know that.
Now they do.
Yeah. You ruined it.
We didn't die.
Yeah, let's head over to this thing.
I'm surprised that we didn't die.
let's max out our ammo real quick. We also have enough money to buy other stuff too. Hollow shield launcher. These are literally just things you can use to. Oh, right. The mods. That's something else I need to explain because I actually remember this.
To modify a weapon, select the weapon you want and press X.
You can modify your
guns. The weapons which are available. With the statistics of the weapon just below, each weapon can equip a powerful Omega modification. These black market upgrades can inflict massive amounts of damage. To add, modify, or change an Omega mod, scroll down to the Omega mod button and press X. The list of available Omega mods will be displayed.
So to explain it easier, there are two different modifications to weapons. Alpha mods, which are essentially just things that a gun would normally have, like how fast it can fire, how much ammo you can carry, how accurate it is, and I don't know what the flag there is. But as you can see, this already comes pre-equipped with a rapid fire mod and a ammo mod. And the Omega mods, which we already saw, we can buy acid and napalm. Those things just do various different effects of add damage.
Gotcha.
But if you want, you can put in like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If you want, you can put 10 rapid fire mods on one gun that fires like a machine gun. Nick and I had so much fun experimenting with these before. So that's something we can do. Is it raining?
Yep.
Yeah, I don't have to cut the grass today. Back to the game! This is something we can do off-camera later. But for now, this is a thing you can do. You can change weapons around.
And modify them.
It looks like we have an extra ammo mod to spare. What should we use it on? It'll just carry more max ammo.
Probably the
impact mod. That's what this thing does. Wait, what the...
I think we already have it.
You have to unlock. Oh, I get it now. You see how there's a whole bunch of different locks on there?
Yeah, and leveling it up.
Exactly, we have two available slots. Okay.
I thought you could, like, choose from those and which one you want, but that's okay.
Wait. Oh, alpha mods, okay.
Yeah.
Max for that. Okay, so...
That makes sense.
Alright, yeah. Anyways, what was I gonna buy now? Now that we've spent a long time explaining how the weapons work. Shield Link or Hollow Shield Launcher? Or the Omega Mods, but...
What does Shield Link do? What does both do?
Shield Link Gadget allows you to create a protective energy shield around an ally during battle, particularly useful when an ally is using the hacker ray or trying to turn one of the... Temporarily creates a shield around your friend. And Hollow Shield Launcher is technically... Stop saying it. Device allows you to shoot out a portable shield at any time and anywhere. The Hollow Shield's patented quantum technology allows you to pass shots through. So it's like Halo 3's bubble shield, if I remember correctly.
So it's either a bubble shield or a shield for yourself.
Well, here's the thing. After, one more arena challenge, we'll be able to afford both.
Yeah. So, might as well get which one do you want. Yeah.
So is that up here on our quick select now? Oh, you can't see where your quick select is when you're out in the hub world. Yeah. So let's go to another challenge. Can Al do anything for us yet? Or is something that's or is she something you can only do in single player mode? I don't remember. Whatever, let's continue battling.
That's weird. L1 also jumps.
Yeah, I noticed that too. I was trying to find the strafe button. I'm like, is it L1? No, that jumps, what the hell? Oh, this is a familiar sight for those of you who have played Ratchet and Clank Going Commando.